Hey guys, welcome back to the Bloom Room. I'm here with my assistant, Chucky. Say hi, Chucky.
Yo.
And today we're going to be doing 20 questions with Steve. I think this is going to be sort of a semi-regular thing. A lot of you don't have a chance to go to conventions, and I know that a lot of you have questions for me. You ask me sometimes on Twitter or my email, and I just don't have time to answer them. So I thought this might be a nice format and give you guys a little shout out in the meantime. So I think we're just going to launch right into it. Starting with at Alora Lang. If you had all the time in the world, which anime would you marathon? I would probably start with Naruto, just because it'll probably take all the time in the world to watch Naruto. There are like 400,000 episodes, right? And I've never really seen the show. I've seen maybe 3 episodes, so I'm kind of curious. At Fifth Dream asks, did you ever have any idea when you started Toonami that you'd be doing it this long? No. I expect to be fired during, before, or after I start pretty much every job. And that way I'm never disappointed. That's sort of partially true, but working on a show like Toonami, that was something completely new for me in my career. I had never hosted anything before. And I was just surprised that anybody was interested in having me do that kind of work. So no, I had no idea. I didn't know what the kind of viewership would be for Toonami either. And I didn't know the full impact of it until I started doing conventions many years later and talking to so many of you who said that you had grown up watching Toonami. You would rush home from school to see it every day, and no, I had no idea. And so thank you guys for tuning in, and thank you for continuing to tune in. We all appreciated it, the show. At Tales of Pants asks, how do you take your coffee? Orally, mostly, and black. At Divine Malzar asks, what are your thoughts on Steampunk Steve? I can't even formulate an opinion on this. I'm just going to show you a couple pictures. At Caboose Jr. asks, how many times have you lost your voice while performing a role? Thankfully, not too many times while whilst performing. It usually happens after the fact. I think the only time I really lost it during a session, I was working on Digimon. And I was doing some big Digimon creature type thing, screaming and yelling and roaring. And then I had to do the voice of Puramon that day, and I couldn't do it. I actually had to cancel the rest of my session and come back in at another time. And I think that's the only time I really lost my voice. I did pass out during an audition once, and I talk about that at conventions before. That was during a Spider-Man game audition. I was right in the middle of the audition, mid-scream for doing a villain, and I literally passed out right in the middle of the session. At Oceano underscore star asks, who serves as the judge for the blooper war against you and Crispin Freeman? I do, and I win. Sorry, Crispin. At Inuyasha Sun 87 asks, why are you rarely in new anime dubs these days? Well, because I live in Los Angeles and most anime dubs are created in Texas. Funimation seems to have most of the business with that. And there are some other ones being done in Canada and elsewhere. And I have to take the work where it is. And I work in Los Angeles and there just isn't a lot of production happening here. It's not that I don't want to do more, it's just not available to me. At Pure OMG, oh, I know this guy, hey dude. Who slash what are some of your biggest inspirations? Well, a quiet environment to record is good. Okay, so that answers the what. Who? I'm inspired every day by people around me. I'm inspired when I go to conventions by you guys, when you're dressing up in your cosplay stuff, when you're sharing your experiences with me. That inspires me probably more than anything else. As far as directly being a voice actor, I would say people like Dee Bradley Baker, Frank Welker, Jim Cummings. There's so many of these really, really great voice actors. Kevin Michael Richardson. There's probably 300 I could mention right here. Just don't have time to. But I'm inspired by the people I work with on a daily basis. Watching their performances are just amazing to me. Even now, knowing the technical aspect of it that I do, knowing what it takes to get to where they are, and still having that enthusiasm every day when you walk into the booth and still coming in there with a sense of gratitude, I think that inspires me more than anything else, and that doesn't just apply to voiceover. At Patrick Sullivan 6 asks, what's your favorite non-voice acting thing to do? be out here in my backyard with my dogs. That's absolutely my favorite thing to do, or to pretty much be anywhere outside. I work inside studios so often that going outside is probably the best thing for my soul. So anytime I can spend time outside is my favorite thing to do. Thank you for your questions, guys. We will be doing this again. I think it's kind of a fun segment, and it gives you guys a chance to get a little bit of a shout out. Gives me a chance to hear what's on your minds. And especially if you can't make it to a convention, I think it's a nice way to pull a little information out of me. Not that it's accurate, or even informative, or even entertaining, but thanks anyway. Thank you for tuning into the Bloom Room, and I'll see you next week. Peace.